G'day guys, Randy here, and I'm just at me and Mark's old stomping ground, Bonoa State High School. So we're gonna go for a kick, and I'll show you around.
Elbow, one, two, bang!
Into their face.
You just
kick them back in.
Fucking hell.
The career centre. Imagine getting careers advice from this bloke. Fucking hell. This is where one of my favourite fights went down. So this guy had just got to our school and he already wanted a shot at the top dog. And his nickname was Wog Nose because he had a really Italian looking nose and he embraced it. He wanted to be called Wog Nose. I walked straight up to him, put the elbow under his throat and I said, you want a shot at the big dog? Let's fucking dance. Credit to Wognose, he was fast and he put a quick 1-2 on me. But I got a pretty good chin, you know? I can take a couple of hits to the chin. So I copped the 1-2 from him and then I gave him the straight uppercut, straight on his beak. And I tell you what, he wasn't called Wognose no more. He was just called Nose because I just straightened it straight up. So Wognose was just here like this. He was just waiting like this. So just giving you guys a little reenactment. I would have been walking down here with a couple of sheilas. How you going, ladies? Beautiful to see us. Give me a little kiss, fucking beautiful. Straight elbow under the neck. Held him there. I whispered in his ear. You want a shot at the top dog? You gotta fucking dance with the devil, cunt. And he's pushed me back, put the 1-2 on me. I've copped it. And then I've just fucking wound up and fucking copped him right in his beak. Fucking, thanks for holding my bag, Steelers. Let's go. And fucking off we went. See you, Terry. It's been real fun hanging out with you. Maybe we'll catch them up. Fucking hell. Have a look at that tuck shop, Mark. They fucking put a cage around it. Treating them like monkeys. Didn't that feel good to be back here in the Venus flytrap, Mark? So just for you guys at home that don't know, this was the Venus flytrap. Me and Mark would be on either side, and as soon as someone went in, we would whistle and trap them. So either way, they're looking at either me or Mark. So that's when we slowly close in on them, and we just fucking pound them, cunts. I'm painting a bad picture, but you know, it was just a couple of rough eggs that me and Mark had to sort out, you know? We did what we had to do. So no qualms for us.
What in the fuck is this? There's fucking showers and there's a window into the showers.
I would have just sat here with my tuck shop and just fucking, hello ladies. Fantastic. This is exactly what we needed when I was at school. Windows into the showers. Fucking beautiful. Hello, Sheilas. Hello, Sally. Hello, Beatrice. Very good to see you. How was your weekend? How are you, sugar? Yeah. Come out here for a hot dog when you're done dressing up. Fucking hell, it would have been magic. Not just showers, they got the toilets with windows. Imagine trying to wipe your anus and you've got people just chit-chatting about their day. Fucking hell. Look at these air conditioning cages. Nice and tucked away for the kids. Keep them out of sight, out of mind. Fucking hell, the gutter, Mark. This is where us and all the boys used to sit. Free brekkie? What? Have a look at this, guys. The free brekkie program. I would have been there fucking 7:30 every week. Oh my God. Coach Nancy. She wasn't there when I was there, but if she was, then I would have had a real hard crack. Now that's a classroom. The footy field. Welcome to my humble abode. Randy Wanless with the kick to win it. The crowd goes up. Randell, Randell, Randell. And he shanks to the right and loses the game. Anyway, the bike racks. Me and Mark were the only seniors riding bikes. So we used to own this shit. So whenever there was a beef between students, we'd all organise it that you met at the bike racks after school. So we'd all meet here. The blokes that were fighting would be inside the cage, would lock the gates, and everyone else would just watch from around the fence. And it would literally be like the octagon. So usually it'd be Mark fighting someone, usually someone that's had a go at him during the week, would tee it up, I'd get on the gate, lock the gate up, and every now and then, you'd get blokes trying to get out. And you just kick them back in. You don't let them back out because you want to see either first blood or a KO. So it was quite a spectacle. I just wish we had phones back in those days to record, you know, the atmosphere. It was fucking ferocious. So that's the school, guys. On a bit of reflection, probably sounds like I was just some aggressive bloke just causing shit, but let me assure you, it was just the bad eggs that deserved it, you know? Lots of good times here, lots of shit stirring, but it's just, you know, the fights always stand out. Ask anyone. Losers or winners of fights. It fucking stains the brain for a long time, you know? For a long time.